Wasn't his album. That was Kanye's album, and Kid Cudi was allowed in the room.
Well, so the premise of that whole thing was that Kanye was going to produce, I think was it
three,
five albums, always seven tracks, and so he did.
Didn't he only do three?
No, he did Pusha T's Their Turner. He did Nas. He did.
I didn't know he did.
Yeah,
Nas.
He did Nas. Oh. He did. Tiana.
Nas sounds Tiana, like a chocolate bar.
Tiana Turner or something like that.
Taylor.
Tiana Taylor. Yeah. Yep. Kids See Ghosts, his own one, yeah. And
you can leave if you want to get drinking water.
Yeah, this sucks.
You just want to go listen to the Shrek theme song as much as you want. So you can feel free to do that.
You know,
this isn't Smash Mouth. I don't know what's going on here.
You know, like, how much that is so not even funny to me, because I genuinely was listening to it on the way. Like, accidentally in love, dude, such a good song. Keelan gets it. Keelan loves Shrek.
I know he does, because when I walked in, his laptop was open and his desktop background is not a whole Shrek.
It's true.
Keelan is the king of backgrounds. We've gone through a few different computers because some of them have died, and I set them up. I put all the editing programs on, and then sometimes I'll check on him and go, "How you going, man?" And the only thing he's done is change the fucking background to something.
There for like 3 hours. Like, how many videos have you edited? He's like, none. But check out this background though. And we're both like, well, that is a pretty cool background. That would have taken a while to select.
I bet you were the type of person to work out who downloaded a thing that changed their background automatically every 30 minutes or something.
Yeah, one point. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Did you guys ever do the one where you change the shortcuts on someone's computer, like when they close a window and it would just start playing like 50 Cent?
Yeah.
Oh, did you ever have that one?
Now just tune out again.
Someone put the Offspring on.
Yeah. You know what this problem is? We have had too many discussions off air, and now he knows too much.
Yeah.
Because one time we did a podcast together that I lost the SD card for. Like, the files got corrupted, was never released. Yeah. But on the podcast, we talked about how shitty my music taste was, and now I don't like that you're using it against me.
Oh, I went through like the whole thing. I was like, you love Smash Mouth.
He predicted all the bands that I like.
I was like, probably it's like Blink 182, Sum 41. Yep. Like, you were probably a big Limp Bizkit fan. Like,
no, that's the only one I will.
Yeah,
not
I think, but I feel the same. It's probably too Lincoln much swearing for you. Yeah. Actually, Mum says I can't do that.
Bizkit has a Z in it. That's not how you spell it.
No, that is how I would spell Bizkit.
Well, why don't you do me? What music do I listen to?
Oh, okay. All right. What music I would expect you to listen to?
Yeah.
Is I'd expect you to be listening to some like something along the lines of like some punk rock stuff, but I don't assume you do. I assume that you're probably like you've got like a hidden guilty pleasure, like you're a big like No Doubt Gwen Stefani fan like that.
You're way off.
You know what I mean? Like something like that. Or also you're like hell into Fall Out Boy. Like you got a picture of Pete Wentz at home
so
on your
wrong.
On your.
You're so wrong. But this is still me.
So No, Aussie rap is what I'm into.
Oh man, that's just even worse. So bad.
Yeah.
It is. It's terrible. Australian rap sucks. No. They're all just rapping about like big, massive world problems that they're gonna fix.
No, while see, that's having... the Oz rap that I don't like.
But that's what Oz rap is. They're all rapping about giant world problems they're gonna fix while they're having a beer with their mates. They're like, oh yeah, Damo's coming round to have some drinks. What about famine? You're like, what? Like, that's what it is.
It is.
No, that's
it's been
the rap
a hard
I don't
road
like, yeah.
And a long war. We should stop and hug more. Like,
yeah. Yeah, I don't
stop
like
rapping
that
about the universe, you knob.
I like Western Sydney rap, talking about dealing drugs and stabbing
more
people.
More fucking blow. Oh, yes, I reckon you fuck like.
You listen
stabbing.
To brag rap.
Yeah, yeah, I like that shit. Yeah,
I like that stuff more.
And
than
I love
like
Rick Ross as well.
Yeah,
sick.
I like Rick Ross because he just goes. There's certain people I just like for their ad-libs on anything.
I'm obsessed with like trash rap, like DJ, like not even rap, like songs that DJ Khaled produces.
you're like, this is my favorite rapper. DJ.
No. No. I'm saying
DJ.
My favorite type of rap songs are the ones where he just brings like four famous people onto a song, and like I don't even know if the people write their own bars, and he just goes DJ Khaled, and he just puts a beat under it, and then he gets like Justin Bieber
McDonald's
to sing the whole
music.
It's so funny to me that they keep coming together because they're like, all right, this will make me millions, but like I want to know is, what is the audience for that song? I want to know what, who goes to a DJ Khaled concert? Does he tour?
Dude,
no, what is that act?
He's really, he's massive, man.
Then what's like, that act, though?
He's so big.
I knew he, like was, he was opening for Jay-Z. I knew that.
You know, DJ Khaled and is like, he kind of started as... online anyways. He's been around for years.
Is he also a YouTube sensation?
He's a Snapchat sensation.
If he called himself that, he never would have made it.
Nah.
People liked DJ Khaled at... First, they laughed at him. Then everyone liked him ironically because of his Snapchats. And then people liked him ironically for so long that... We just like him now, and
oh,
he's just
no,
a guy.
He's like, he's an, I think he's like an amazing like eye for talent. Like he definitely takes like he goes, right, this person, if I put them all together and just make this very like complimentary beat to all of them, it's like very easy on the ears, it will be number one. It's like he has like a matrix.
And then
like
my favorite is like, that he just watermarks his own music. He's like, DJ, that's like if when people put their little Instagram handle on like a video in case DJ someone else rips it. Yeah. It's like, oh, I wonder who sings this song. DJ! Oh, okay, cool.
You know why?
Because it's hilarious. You can't even do the impression of him. And it's one of the easy, like, DJ.
Oh, yours was so great. You do it.
That's what me doing, you doing Khaled.
Okay, you do.
Yeah, you do actual Khaled.
DJ Khaled!
You're that's too British.
DJ Khaled!
DJ Khaled!
You do it.
Mine was the best one. Yours was too Australian, and yours was too British. Too British, and mine did suck a little bit.
You were doing it like you were like announcing like the
hey,
winner.
Hey, sound
of
off
a
in the comments below. Who did the best DJ?
Sound off. Sound off. Write your comment. Do it silently.
But Rory, you've been you just got back from Asia.
Yes. Yes.
So you were kind of touring Asia, doing all the comedy clubs.
Yeah, I
there.
Did. I did seven shows in 13 days, I think.
Yeah.
In Malaysia, Singapore, and Thailand. And I was supposed to go to Hong Kong, but apparently that country was on fire.
What? Still is.
Yeah, it's still pretty hectic.
Yeah. They just pulled out.
Is that why you actually didn't go?
Yeah. Yeah. I was like, oh.
Have you seen it?
So was your trip cut short?
No, I just didn't book that gig. Right. I had it like booked in. But
yeah, I thought you meant it got like cancelled last minute and then they just sent you somewhere else.
Well, I go to London on Tuesday and I got to fly through Hong Kong. So like there might be issues.
You might not make it. They're blocking the airport. Like 100,000 people go to the airport to stand there.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good job I'm not walking in. I'm flying in.
Yeah.
You know, it's like they're all just there like...
No, I mean they go in the airport and they will literally not let anyone board or any of the flights.
Yeah, so you might just get stuck on a runway.
Well, I'll be in transition, so I should be okay.
You should be, yeah.
Yeah, it's not like I'm coming out and having a chocolate and then walking back in. Not that like Hong Kong's big for chocolates, but
it's like not like that was a good example.
I'm just hungry. I want a Kit Kat.
I'll get you one after this.
Yeah,
what I noticed from watching your like Instagram stories and stuff while you were there was. It seemed like your Thailand accommodation was nice.
Yeah.
Fancy. Five stars. And then
Thailand's good.
Your Kuala Lumpur accommodation was not nice.
No, Kuala Lumpur was pretty nice. I had a whole
Singapore
apartment.
Singapore supposed to be nicer?
Well, Singapore is, it's a really nice country. Like it's super clean.
Shit's actually
gorgeous,
expensive
but
there.
Hell expensive. Yeah. So I think, because I have to pay like a deposit like whenever I'm touring, like pay a deposit for the hotel and you walk in there.
So you live like a king in the third world.
Yeah.
You're like a third world king.
Yeah,
you're
third
not
world
like
king,
a,
baby. That's
you
that's
go to like
just
sure,
being
third
white
king.
In Asia?
But they put me in a hotel in Singapore, right? And the dude that sent me the itinerary and stuff was like, oh, this is the hotel you're in. I'm like, all right, sick. I'll check it out.
Yeah.
Just so I'm not like, oh, fuck, what am I walking into? And the description is a very spacious 8 square meters.
What?
Yeah.
That's not
8
spacious.
Square meters.
That's not spacious.
First of all, you can't make it more or less spacious. That's exactly how much it is. It's 8 square meters.
It should
meters.
Say exactly,
yeah,
8
exactly 8 square meters. Yeah. But I walk in and as
maybe
I open
they
the
put
door,
mirrors in it.
The there was a lot of mirrors.
Yeah,
there
to
was
make
a lot
it
of mirrors.
Seem bigger.
As I walk in, the door doesn't fully open because it hits the bed.
Very spacious.
I was like, what? And like, I've got to like, you know when you like shimmy like into a gap to like pull the thing back? And I was like, all right, cool. And I just looked at the room and I went, and I touched both walls. It's like, oh, this room's so small. And
so I wouldn't fit in there.
No, not at all. You would like, it was tiny.
If your
like,
wingspan is bigger than the room, it's not spacious.
No. Yeah, no, not at all.
You shouldn't have to, shimmy into your through a door. Yeah.
Also,
dumb cunt can be fooled by a mirror? Like, you put them in a box and they're like, this is
guy.
Really small.
Chuck this a mirror guy can be. I was like, oh, there's another room. No, there's not another room. It's just me.
Have I ever told you that I always do that drunk?
Well, okay.
It's like one
I've just
things.
Realized who I'm sitting in a room
I
with.
Did it.
A couple of dumb
I did it on the weekend. So I was like catching up with Lane. We had a couple of beers. We went to a kebab shop and the kebab shop had a mirror at the side. And I was saying that
they shouldn't have
waiting
that.
For my kebab legit was like, who the fuck's that guy looking at? And then I was like, oh, that's... And I was like, oh, that's me. And I realized, like, I need to stop looking less staunch because I was ready to fight me.
You never look staunch.
Dude, apparently...
No, he does. At nighttime, he's on edge.
I feel like...
Apparently, like, I was just sitting there waiting and I was like, what the fuck's this guy's problem? Then I was like, oh, shit, dude, I need to change my attitude.
Yeah, you're very pale.
People,
like, you do look like you could,
don't
like,
realize that,
graph
that
up
Luke,
a bus stop.
That Luke, you could... You don't think so, but you could... He's the type of guy that you could trust in a fight because normally... Like, if you were to fight him in, like, a boxing ring, you'd probably win, right?
I'd be terrible.
But on the street, he'll snap and turn into an animal.
I got, like, I had, like, white line fever. I had to quit footy.
White line fever?
Yeah.
Well, quit footy.
One time, yeah, no, I had to quit footy, dude, because... Because what...
No, fuck it. I did. I had to quit footy.
No, it's just, like, one time I had my shirt ripped and, like, and I had to, like... Have a meeting with like the umpires stuff. Like it was bad, man.
So wait.
Luke actually doesn't remember what happened. This is just all third party. He blacked out.
No. Someone ripped your shirt.
Yeah, like no,
and they
like,
were like, he can't play footy anymore.
No, like I just used to like get like, and that's the thing. I'm not good at fighting, but it like so therefore I used to get like beaten up a lot.
Are you like, you just like, start all, and lose.
I would
all
start
his
and
fight.
Lose fights.
That's
but
crazy.
I was a great runner. Like I was always into cross country. So I would like, I was just an asshole.
Because he's always running directly.
But the thing
punches.
Is, I'm like, I would think you'd agree. Like, I'm a pretty nice guy. You're probably like, oh yeah, Luke, he's a, you know.
You are a nice guy because I know you, but you also look like you could have like a string Nike backpack with like big pens in it.
Yeah.
And you just like
that's
draw
more Lewis's
stuff.
Vibe.
Yeah? Nah, he's too tall to be graffitiing. People see him.
And I have horrible handwriting.
Yeah. But you know what else? Apparently people always say I sound like really staunch when I answer the phone. Have you ever called me? Dude, my management complained about it. They're like, hey, man, like, you need to change your attitude. Like, because I just go, yeah, hey. And I'm not trying to be a dick, but maybe audibly it sounds worse. But I'm happy. I've, like, got a smile face. I'm like, yeah, hey. And
no,
everyone's
you sound
like
an asshole.
One time, Elliot Loney called me, and he goes, dude, are you okay? And I was like, yeah, I'm fine. He's like, are you sure?
Yeah.
He's like, he thought, he was like.
You're a douche on the phone.
He goes, are you mad at me? And I was like, no. What do you mean I'm a douche?
No, you're not. You just sound like it. You're not mean on the phone, but you. Like anything that comes across as slightly mean, you would interpret as, oh, wow, he's really angry.
Yeah.
I don't picture you as
an
angry person.
I just speak monotone and I
right
don't...
now, though, you've definitely got like a triple one look. You've got like...
Well, that's because I'm wearing Lewis Spears merch
yeah, you've
and
got
a cap.
Like, fuck
I have
like,
bed hair.
Yeah, the hat. The hat's selling it. All black, bit of
white.
See,
if you want to look like you have a knife, lewisspears.com/merch. That's what you should get.
Yeah.
Sound off. Comment in the comments if you've got a knife.
Yeah. If you want to know how to conceal a weapon, loosebeers.com/.
Long sleeves.
Yeah. And if you want to learn how to like conceal a tambourine or something, lukekidzor.com.
If you want to learn how to get banned from the AFL.
Yeah.
Follow Luke Kidzor.
I didn't get banned. I just didn't want to play anymore.
The real Melbourne demon.
Sick of being punched in the head.
But yeah, so like Singapore is just, it's crazy expensive. And so, like, the accommodation's
yeah,
bullshit.
I've never been.
But then you go to... I went to Thailand straight after. And then, yeah, it was, like, 14 pools.
You were living in luxury,
like,
man.
It was... They had a... not only did I have a robe, I also had, like, slippers with, like, the initials
yeah, I had that
of the
with,
things on. I was like, fuck yeah, I'm taking these.
Yeah,
oh, but you know what? They charge you for it. So whoever,
don't charge
whoever
me.
Booked you,
I didn't pay
we got
room.
Charged for it. Because I went to Thailand and we were going to take the robes back, but then we luckily on the way out we saw the price of the robe was $60 if you leave the room with it.
Yeah. Shit. Have you seen that? Because like, they leave the price of what everything in the room costs if you steal it. Yeah,
you could probably take the fucking bed if you want.
What you do is find something that's not on that list
and then take it.
And then take it. I've got a wicked painting at home.
Man, one of the rudest things I ever did was we were out with friends on a night out, and then
did you just get I that just joke? Just like chilling, like laugh, like 10 seconds later, he's like, "Oh, good one."
She's looking at his, he's choosing a new background.
Yeah.
Shrek 2, maybe?
He's just googling Shrek facts. You know, sometimes he just stops the podcast to give us a Shrek fact. So if any point if you find the conversation boring, like if they yeah. start talking about rap again, just stop them and give them a Shrek fact. Shrek
yeah. Fact, so. Whoa, wow, where'd my pink hoodie come from? Your hat's all different. Where's Rory gone?
Oh no, it must be t-